Why you should own at least 5,000 Ripple tokens. Hello guys, welcome back to the Crypto Diary. After this video, you will learn well-researched reasons why you should own at least 5,000 Ripple tokens. Already in the news because of the US Securities and Exchange Commission's seemingly circuitous lawsuit, Ripple appears to be taking heat now. But we all know that this is a classic case of the people versus the government. So those who know better keep buying XRPs at their lows while they wait for the inevitable spike in price when the whole suit is over. XRP remains one of the 10 biggest cryptos in the world. With a strong use case and high-profile financial partnerships, Ripple surely has lots of room to grow. At this video's production, an XRP is $0.6704. We know this isn't XRP's real price, no thanks to SEC's witch hunting. Ripple sure has the capacity to do better than $0.6704. Nevertheless, I guess you're already thinking what I'm thinking. So here is my Ripple mantra. Those who are there for the lows truly deserve the highs. Before I go on, have you heard about the Token Metrics platform? It is an accessible crypto analytics platform where you can make crypto profits like never before. There you can find 100 times cryptocurrency gems and accurate bearish and bullish predictions. With Token Metrics, you also get the fast profits of trading with the slow, oversized profits of buy and hold. Hop there now to register. For Ripple, 2021 certainly didn't start nicely. After years of trailing Bitcoin and Ethereum in third place as per market cap, the US Securities and Exchange Commission, also known as SEC, decided to turn its back on them. I'll explain this shortly. Ripple isn't a regular cryptocurrency. It is a venture-backed startup that offers financial settlement services to banks, which allows them to make transactions directly and instantly across international borders. Owing to this, Ripple is usually seen as more oriented towards large institutions instead of individual users. Since Ripple came on board, it has partnered with large banks around the world, like Bank of America, and more financial institutions are looking into how they could best use the Ripple protocol. But as I've mentioned earlier, things aren't looking particularly great for Ripple. They used to be close with SEC, but aren't anymore. SEC claims that Ripple had violated security laws by selling XRP tokens to retail investors over several years, and is now suing them. SEC is insisting that Ripple should be recognized as a security and not a cryptocurrency. For a long time, everyone in the crypto universe saw this coming, but didn't know when it'll happen and which crypto it would hit first. As expected, the lawsuit pummeled XRP's value in a very short amount of time, dropping to dips we haven't seen in years. Now, while this sounds like bad news, it's not. Firstly, Ripple has a great chance of beating the SEC in their court case. SEC doesn't appear to fully understand what Ripple is and how it works. Secondly, even if the SEC makes some noise with Ripple, it won't stop them in the end. Ripple will eventually move on and recover. As I earlier hinted, what crypto traders like you should be thinking is loading up XRPs, because now is the time of opportunity. The third reason why SEC's lawsuit is good in the long term for Ripple is its price correlation with Bitcoin, meaning Bitcoin's recent spike in value could cause Ripple's value to go up too. Just a fact to cheer you up, Ripple has been winning its case against the SEC so far. What is Ripple? For those who don't know much about Ripple, it is a technology that works as both a crypto and a digital payment network for financial transactions. It was launched in 2012 and co-founded by Chris Larson and Jed McCaleb. Ripple's major process is a payment settlement asset exchange and remittance system like SWIFT. The SWIFT system for international money and security transfers is used by banks and financial middlemen that deal across currencies. Ripple is the name of the company and the network, and XRP is the crypto token. The purpose of XRP is to serve as an intermediate mechanism of exchange between two currencies or networks. How Ripple works. The Ripple network doesn't run with a proof-of-work POW system like Bitcoin or a proof-of-stake POS like Polkadot. Instead, transactions rely on a consensus protocol to validate account balances and transactions on the system. The consensus works to enhance the integrity of the system by preventing double spending. Ripple operates on an open-source and peer-to-peer decentralized platform that allows for easy transfer of money in any form, whether it is dollars, rand, euros, or crypto like Ethereum or Bitcoin. Ripple is a global payments network and counts major banks and financial services among its customers. So XRP is used in its products to facilitate quick conversion between different currencies. To understand how XRP works, look at this. Ripple's digital currency, XRP. XRP acts as a bridge currency to other currencies. It doesn't discriminate between any fiat or crypto, and that makes it easy for any currency to be exchanged for another. Each currency on the ecosystem has its own gateway, for example, CADBLAZEL, USD SnapSwap, and BTC Bitstamp. If user A wants bitcoins as a payment for the services rendered to user B does not necessarily have to have any bitcoins. He can send the payment to his gateway in Canadian dollars, CAD, and user A can receive bitcoins from his gateway. With that said, here is one of some upcoming Ripple projects. Federated sidechains. According to David Schwartz, who is Ripple's chief technology officer, we will be seeing federated sidechains on Ripple's network soon. Schwartz thinks that this would enable the implementation of smart contracts adjacent to the XRP ledger. Federated sidechains for the XRP ledger are expected to help developers implement native smart contracts that interact with both XRP and XRP ledger while keeping the ledger efficient. What this means is that the sidechains would allow for more specialized products to be built using Ripple's functionality without compromising the security or efficiency of the ledger. Here is some Ripple news. National Bank of Egypt and Lulu International Exchange connect through RippleNet. The National Bank of Egypt and Lulu International Exchange recently connected through RippleNet to elevate remittance experience into Egypt. The National Bank of Egypt is the country's largest bank, while Lulu International Exchange is part of the Lulu Financial Group based in the UAE. The goal is to process frictionless cross-border payments for customers in the Middle East and North African regions. This would be powered by RippleNet's blockchain tech. Ripple acquires 40% stake in Asia's leading cross-border payment specialists, Trango. In Ripple's global quest to be the foremost cross-border payment specialist, they have recently acquired Trango. Trango is the biggest cross-border payment setup. This partnership will help Ripple to meet the soaring customer demand in Asia and expand the reach of RippleNet, which uses XRP to instantly send money and reduce working capital needs. Having said that, here is why I think you should own at least 5,000 XRPs. Number 1, it's a crypto designed for financial institutions. Before investing in any crypto, one of the most important things to consider is the coin's purpose. Many new cryptos fall short in this regard, as they don't have a defined purpose or they don't do anything different than dozens of other coins. As a crypto investor, this should be on your mind before deciding on which coins to add to your investment portfolio. XRP is different because it is intended for financial institutions and payment services, unlike other cryptos that are targeted at customers. In using XRP, banks and other financial companies can transfer money without needing to pre-fund accounts in other countries or pay huge foreign exchange fees. So financial institutions would always want to integrate Ripple's technology into their setup as they seek to be on top of technological developments in their niche. That is a great XRP price catalyst, if you ask me. Number 2, its goal is to improve international money transfers. You already know by now, Ripple is an expert in cross-border transfers. They have positioned themselves as a competitor to SWIFT, the system many financial institutions use for international money transfers. That's why they offer a global payments network called RippleNet to facilitate international money transactions. Financial institutions that use RippleNet can also enjoy the privilege of using XRP for their money transfers. Number 3, transactions are fast and cheap. XRP has two big advantages over others, its speed and the low cost of every transaction. A standard transaction on Ripple costs 0.00001 XRP. That is very cheap at the current XRP price of under $1. More so, the average transaction time is 5 seconds. Overall, XRP is a very efficient way to transfer money. Number 4, it has partnerships with more than 300 financial companies. Hundreds of financial companies across over 40 nations have signed up to use Ripple. Some of them include Santander, Bank of America, TransferGo, ExenderPay, American Express. But it will take some doing to dispose SWIFT in the number one spot as the biggest player in cross-border transactions. SWIFT has more than 11,000 partners compared to Ripple with more than 300. But don't forget that SWIFT has been around since the 1970s, while Ripple launched in 2012. It has a promising future. Number 5, it's trading well below its all-time high from 2018. Only a few cryptos have gone past their previous highs in 2021, but XRP is an exception. Its high point was in 2018 when it hit $3.84. XRP has followed the rest of the crypto market's ups and downs to an extent, and its price reached $1.9 in April 2021. Since then, it has dropped to about $0.6704 at the time of this video. The SEC lawsuit is really taking a massive toll on XRP. That is why I believe that now is the best time to invest in Ripple. The world is closely monitoring the Ripple lawsuit. The day the lawsuit will end will send a massive wave of FOMO investors worldwide, racing to accumulate XRP, and it will send the price up north than previously expected. Ripple price prediction. Ripple looks set to win the court case against SEC, which would most likely send it soaring towards a new all-time high. Ripple has the potential to disrupt the financial system positively. In fact, it is already doing so as more central banks across the world want to use XRP as their payment settlement coin. In the short term, I'm predicting $1.5 per token and $4 per token in the long term with a fully diluted market cap of over $350 billion. Don't make the mistake of waiting for the SEC suit to wrap up before buying in bulk. Remember, those who are there for the lows truly deserve the highs. Please note that I'm not a financial advisor. This video is only for educational use. If you want to invest in VeChain, please go beyond the findings in this video with your own research. Thanks for watching.